Greetings, this is Lanice McGee with Lanice Leeds, and I am bringing to you today a poem that I wrote back in 2006 called Black Hero. And I think it's appropriate right now with us just celebrating Juneteenth not that long ago and just what's all going on in the world. And so here it goes, Black Hero. Black man, we are fighting a war we may never win. Black and brave is what they'll say. Black man living in America today. To live in peace is what you're fighting for. Justice for all is what you want to ensure. Fight for freedom is what you'll hear. Black and brave, the black soldier today. With sure hands and a strong heart, his soul goes marching on and on. He is a hidden contributor of what we are today. In our own image is what we see. A black man struggling so that I might be free. Escape the hidden pain that lies within your soul, or you'll always be enslaved even though you're free to go. Black man, don't stand there depressed. Be proud of who you are and strive to do your best. Keep your head up high and let the rivers run deep. Treat others with love and respect, and one day you'll see we will reach equity. Black man, stand tall. Black man, be strong. Black man, you are a natural born soldier. Black man, you are a leader of your time. A leader of this time. Black and brave, the black hero today. So yeah, I think that is so appropriate with what is going on, and I'm displaying this shirt of a black leader right now in our community, and it says March America, receive collective healing. And I think it's so important that we all are marching, and I don't just mean marching literally, but that's important as well. But how are you marching? All of us can march, right? And so what is your area of influence? If you are in education, how can we change the way our youth are educated? Do you have influence to do that? In our healthcare, do you have influence to help change, to make sure that everybody is getting equal access to health? What is your area of influence? That's where you need to march. That's where your voice needs to be heard. So those that are marching out and visually being seen saying enough is enough, you can march as well in your area of influence and say enough is enough, because you might be in spaces where your voice will be heard, where your voice will carry weight. Some of you are the only one. And you know what I mean. You might be the only woman, the only African American, the only something in a room. And you have an opportunity to share your voice in a way with people that other people like you may never be able to speak to. And so share your voice. Maybe you are a writer, and I've heard some beautiful songs and even inspiring raps, where people who may not ever go in one area, but they will listen to your song because you have influence in music. Write that song, say that poem, write that book. Where's your area of influence where you can march and make a difference? And if we all do our part, that's how we march. That's how we get healing. And so I encourage you today to be a hero that we all need. What area of influence can you change? Maybe you are in a financial situation where you can invest. Invest into a community that has been forgotten. And don't just invest your dollars, but invest your dollars and invest ways that will help that community sustain. Not just here's the money, build it. No, here's the money, build it. And here's the infrastructure. And here's the education. And here's everything you need so that you can thrive. And so that's where we are. We all want to thrive and we all want to get ahead. And so I encourage you all to march in your area of influence. We all need to do this to get collective healing. So thank you and have a great day.